College of Engineering, Trichy. He has acquired his bachelor degree to distinction from JACS ICSE, Anna University, Chennai. He also acquired his master's degree in computer science and engineering with distinction from MS University, Philadelphia. He is currently doing his doctorate in information and communication engineering in Anna University, Chennai. His academic experience in teaching is 11 years and 5 months. Award of Excellence, the Cash Award of Rs. 5,000 from IIT Bombay for top performers in the OSI AICTE approved FD by IIT Bombay on use of ICT education for online and blending learning, held from 2nd day to 10th July 2016. It has been a review of 46 journals so far and few review journals on IEP, Image Processing, 9 papers written. Sprinkle wireless personal communication. Elsewhere, computers and electrical engineering, 5 papers written. He also reviewed on conference as a reviewer, ISSPIT 2016, the 16th IEEE International Symposium on Signal Processing and Information Technology, held on 14th December 2016, Limassol, with press 2 papers written. He presented 112 papers on FDP, seminars, and workshops. Also attended and organized 21 workshop seminars and activities so far. He has published 3 books and 2 articles. He is a member in Indian Society of Technical Education, MISTE, Institute of Engineers, AMIE, International Association of Engineers, IAENG. Scale-ups of interest of video technology, cloud computing, web design, image and video processing. Achieved this degree by also attending numerous workshops. In the year 2008, on 24 July, he has presented a seminar on the topic Internet Usage in Dr.Sivanthi, Aditanar College of Engineering, Trichy. He recently presented a guest lecture on the topic Big Data Analysis with Hadoop in Department of Application, Govindam Palanikkanna College of Government, Trichy, on 24 January 2017, and also much more. It is our inner special to have such an amazing chief guest on this event. On behalf of CSC Department, I proudly invite you to sir. Welcome, sir.
HDFS and then MAPREDUCE. It's a team of one day agenda. Before starting session, there's a small tutorial in the presentation department. I should represent something. Even a bat can operate a mobile phone. So technology is for everyone. So everyone can learn Hadoop, HDFS, as well as MAPREDUCE. It's a team of one day agenda. Anyway, there is a very small agenda for the whole day. One day, so very, very small agenda. Very small introduction on big data. What is big data as well as big data analysis? One or two slides, at least for 10 to 15 minutes. Very small intro on what is big data, why it's needed. Anyway, installation of SQL, actually installation of SQL will take half an hour. So we will not waste the time. So already the operating system should be installed on all the machines. So just 2 slides, how to install SQL without deleting the Windows operating system. So just 2 slides for how to install SQL. Hadoop installation to create a single node cluster. With the help of a single machine, how to create a HDFS environment. So Hadoop installation, not installation, Hadoop manipulation. Then, how to mount a file system? Because Hadoop distributed file system is a file system. So how to mount a new file system? And actually, are more familiar about Windows operating system. Because of its user interface. Similar way, how to use Hadoop user interface. So, find user interface. Anyway, all are more familiar about programming. So, something, very basic program, how to manage Hadoop configuration as well as Hadoop operation via Java AP. At last, an excellent MapReduce program via MapReduce as well as electricity management. So, there are 2 applications. So, it's a very small agenda for the whole thing. Fine? Before starting a session, there is a small puzzle after that installation. What's the name? Greatest mind reader. Actually, the name says greatest mind reader. So it reads all your mind. Fine. Just a small puzzle. Please pick a 2-digit number. Please pick a 2-digit number. How many 2-digit number lies between 10 to 99? Pick a 2-digit number. digit number. Yeah, I'm also giving a 2-digit number. The number was 23. Add the 2 digits. Add the 2 digits. 2 plus 3, that is 5. Now I'm having 2 numbers on my hand. One is 23, the original number 23. After that is the addition result 5. Subtract the result, that is 5, from the original number 23. Subtract the addition result 5 from the original number 23. That's fine. How to have a result on your mind? Yeah, that is the whole. Which having number lies between 0 to 99. Each and every number in the right hand side, that is simple. How to knowing your result? That's fine. Yeah. Please see the symbol relevant to your result. Please see the symbol relevant to your result. That's fine. Yes. 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 Generate of mind reader. So it reads all your mind. Yes or no? It reads all your mind. That is possible. Anyway, just for another try, pick another 2-digit number. Pick another 2-digit number. Add the 2 digits. Subtract the result from the original number. Subtract the result from the original number. Yeah, there is a more. Which every number lies between 0 to 99. Each and every number in the right hand side has a symbol. Yeah, please see the symbol for the result. That's fine. Yes? How is possible? Just a mathematical trick which reads all your mind. Last try, pick another 2-digit number, add the 2 digits, subtract the result from the original number. That's fine. The results are 27, 36, 35, 54, 63, 72, 81. Please see the book. Yeah, that is summation of 9. If you are adding 2 digits and subtract from the result, then the results are summation. Well, it is in the help of Hadoop. So very, very small intro on big data. What is big data? Actually, big data, as the name itself says, large amount of data. How much amount of data we are saying? Large amount of data. I think 10 years back, 10 or 15 years back, in that situation, there is a floppy drive of 1.44 MB. In that situation, 2 MB of data should be termed as large data. Because for holding the data, which means another floppy drive. After a period of time, 701 MB, because the CD consists of 700 MB. So 701 MB data should be termed as big data. The period of time, 4.5 GB, 40 GB, 100 GB. Then what is big data actually? What is big data? How much amount you are saying big data? So that is a small vectorial representation which says that. Please see the picture. A human being, the person, they are holding a large stone. Yes or no? They are holding a large or big stone. Why you are saying it's a big stone? Beyond his capability, he takes this stone. Yes or no? Beyond his capability, he can approach the stone. Based on the person's capability, the stone should be called a big stone. Yes or no? Similarly, big data is amount of data just beyond the technology's capability. It's amount of data. The technology capability was 1.44 MB. In that situation, 2 MB should be termed as big data. If the technology capability was 700 MB, that is CD, in that situation, 701 MB should be termed as big data. So, amount of data just beyond the technology's capability to store, to manage, to process. Based on storage, based on managing the data, or based on processing the data, based on any ability, should be termed as big data. It's a very small data. What is big data? So, amount of data just beyond technology capability. The data was classified into 3 basic categories. First one called the structured data. All are more familiar about the data. So, the data are well organized. Second one, which will be called as semi-structured data. It's also managed. Last one, which will be called as unstructured data. It's a typical one to manage the data. Yeah, first one, structured data. Normal relational database management system. We are having date, author name, place, and subjects. So date which having a data type called as date. Then author name which having a data type called as varchar. Then subject which having a data type called as varchar. So each and every data are predefined by their structure. Already it should be defined. The size of author, that is varchar of 10. So maximum letters of author is 10 characters. So already the structure is properly defined. So managing data is very, very easy. Managing these kind of data are very, very easiest one. So structured data is not a problem. Second one, partially structured, partially unstructured data, for example, Excel, Microsoft Excel. So, data is partially structured one, including partial unstructured one. In Excel, also manageable. Example, comma separated value, which are every data. Roll number, comma name, comma mark one, comma mark. Data are separated by comma. It's also manageable. Example, yeah, use a defined data type. JavaScript object notation, yeah, it's also manageable. Not only SQL database. These are some sort of examples for semi-structured data. These data are also manageable. The data are unstructured. In that situation, the problem. Data are unstructured. Then in that situation, how to manage these amount of data? Example data. Satellite images, images, multimedia images, video files, scientific data, video, radar data, normal black file, PDF file, image files. Yeah, all of you are familiar about social media like WhatsApp and Facebook. Yeah, it's the greatest problem for big data. So, there are several set of bits, several set of messages, several set of forward messages. Even a second, they can forward 1000 messages. Even a second, they can forward 1000 people. Just even a group having 250 people. Fraction of second, they forward to 10 or 20 users. They think about situation. So, storage was big data. Then, last one, website and apps like blog, Instagram, etc. These are some examples for the data are not having power. Think about your Microsoft bad file. The bad file is consisting of text. After that, which also having image, which also having clipboard file. Then the data are X number, the images, the number of pages, yeah, data are not also important. So if you call this unstructured data, fine. Anyway, starts with the small intro on storage system. Our concept is about storage system. Anyway, how much amount of data will be called as big data? It's easy. So starts with storage system. 1024 bytes will be called as kilobytes. After a period of time, it will be extended up. Megabyte, yeah, fine. Then gigabyte. I'm representing these three in blue color. So these three are easily manageable. Not easily manageable. Easily manageable with the help of a laptop or computer. These amount of data are easily manageable by a laptop or computer. Fine. The second thing that is large color. Terabytes and petabytes. Terabyte of data as well as petabyte of data. Petabytes. Yeah, now it's very, very difficult for managing, for finding a data, or for searching a data, or for mining a data. From this amount of big data is very, very tough as well. It will take 1 day, 10 days, 20 days. After 20 days, you are finding a name from your database. Very, very tough as well. So, this amount of data, for managing this amount of data, it needs an excellent tool called as Hadoop and MISTE. Anyway, the next stage is in your hand. Current state depends on Hadoop and MySQL. Next stage, even 1 or 2 days, the data size was again big data. The next stage, in that situation, you can develop a new tool standard. It's a theme of it. They are more familiar about the term called as iceberg, yes? Yeah, if you are reading that, it's small. For example, if you are reading data, the data size was bigger space to print, the size was small. But even if you can damage a very large system. Similarly, if you are properly managing your data, then only it's possible for managing your system, managing your process, managing your storage. Otherwise, it's very, very tough. If you say something was very big, then in that situation it's not possible for studying something. Similarly, don't say big data, say smart data. So the theme of the seminar was extract smart data from big data. The major theme of seminar, how to extract the smart data from this amount of big data. That's fine. Anyway, the flight which travel from Bangalore to US. The flight which travel from Bangalore to US. The distance was 8,699 miles. Then, even the journey was 22 hours, which will generate thousands. The airport management system, single journey which record 1,700 terabytes of data. How to manage, how to analyze, how to process, how to store these amount of data. It's not the easiest one. So in that situation, it needs an excellent tool. A tool needs to be used. learned from the technologies will be called as 3D technologies. That's the technologies will be called as 3D technologies. The 3Ds are volume, velocity, and variety. The 3Ds will be called as volume, velocity, and variety. As the name itself, volume, so large in size. Fine. Then, velocity, the data set comes in motion, that is in our screen. Then, variety, which comes from variety of sources. I'm giving you a very small example. For example, if you are thinking about a dam, think about a dam. The dam size was 120 feet. All those 120 feet was filled with water. The dam was filled with water. All those 120 feet are filled with water. It will be called as volume. The static size was filled. The static size of dam was filled. That will be called as volume. The total volume was filled. Then second time, that in addition to that, the dam is receiving water from hills. The dam is receiving water from hills in a very, very rapid manner. So its velocity already filled. Now it is receiving water in a very, very rapid manner. It will be called as velocity. In that situation, there was a rain. Then the water also received from already received from hill. Now it's from rain. Then water received from variety of sources. It's from rain. Then how to manage the data? Already dam filled. Yes. It receives water from hills. Yeah, fine. Then now there is a rain. Receive water from variety of sources. How to manage? It's a big data problem. It's a problem of big data. Small Victorian presentation. Volume. Yeah, we have volume. In the sense, already everything was low. So there is a small difference. Volume was very large. Velocity, the data set comes in very, very rapid manner. So velocity. Yeah, data set in variety of flavors. Yeah, variety of sources. So it will be symbolically represented as variety of flavors. That's fine. Yes, volume. Volume was big in the picture. All the black dots are free. So volume was free. Yes. Then second stage, in addition to that, which receives the data, data of emotion. Yes. Variety. Again, the data are receiving variety of colors. So this is variety of sources. So volume, velocity, variety. So big data depends on 3D technology. First view should be termed as volume. Second view should be termed as velocity. Third view should be termed as variety. Anyway, in addition to that, the fourth view should be added. The fourth view, that is value, velocity, or it should be called as value. Fourth view should be called as value or velocity. That is data in terms. The originality of the data, whether the data is correct or not. And say the definition. Definition of computer. The computer is an electronic device, they are fine. It's used to perform arithmetic and logical operation. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, fine, very good. Then. Asking another question. Different computer. Calculator is an electronic device which is used to perform arithmetic and logical operation.
Your definition says calculator is conducting arithmetic.
Your definition is then how the truthfulness of data.
So the data is correct or not?
I'm saying big data. It's a data just beyond the technology's capability. Whether the data is correct or not, whether the information is correct or not, how to verify? How to verify the velocity of data? This is the definition of computer. All the other devices are already programmed. Now, computers have an excellent capability called as programmability. So, the definition has changed. Computers are programmable electronic device which used to perform arithmetic and logical operation. Then only the term was correct. Term was perfectly fit for the situation. Yes, sir. So, the verified truthfulness of data is essential. Anyway, all those data are stored, it's not a problem. But verification is essential. That's fine. So, 4P should be added. Volume, velocity, variety in addition to the verification of data. That is values are added. Anyway, the storage size in the year 1980, even 128 MB, the storage size. Now, even 4GB, 128GB, yeah, even 64GB memory card, very, very tiny in size. So after we delete today, big data tomorrow's little data. It's not about today's big data, tomorrow's little data. Because what it takes to every should be called as big data. After that, 7 or 8 should be called as big data. Now you are saying petabyte of data should be called as big data. So today's big data, tomorrow's little data, based on your research. Otherwise, it's not about based on your research, based on your analytical tools, it says today's big data, tomorrow's little data. Using MapReduce algorithm, you can extract smart information. So only two things. First one, how to upload a data to HDFS. The first one, how to upload a data to HDFS, how to balance a load. Then second stage, how to use the MapReduce program for our application. Because MapReduce program is available in internet. But how to apply this program, map and reduce operation to our application. This is the second. Then how to run Java program, using Java, how to compile a Java program? Java C, pylame.java. How to run a Java program?
Java
class name is fine. So, how to compile, how to run, it's common. So, similar way, here, in the Java page, you can compile and then run the Java. It's not a problem. Fine. Just for how to make big data to smart data. For example, normally everyone updating Facebook. Similarly, it's also my target. So I'm also updating my Facebook status. Just for them, I'm updating the Facebook status. The status was. What's that?
Yes.
Yeah, anyway, that's for fun. I'm updating my Facebook status was feeling sad. Yeah, that's fine. That's not a problem. Immediately, my friends and relatives, everyone responded with different set of comments, different set of minds. Many of you likes, yeah, it's not a problem. Anyway, it's fine. So, actually, I just place a single line, feeling sad. But everyone makes it as big data. Yeah, that's not a problem. So, extend it. But the market intelligent people, the business intelligent people, actually, the Facebook have a separate set of things. The business intelligent people, they analyze the data, they analyze some Facebook tweets, each and every tweet they analyze it across their base. What's that? If I'm feeling sad, I need a touchy. If I'm feeling sad, I need a touchy. So immediately the touchy foundation should be placed like that. Just for fun. Anyway, if I'm placing a Facebook status as feeling sad, immediately the touchy foundation should be placed like that. If I'm placing my Facebook status as it was raining, if I'm placing Facebook status, I'm in Trichy, so I'm placing my Facebook status as raining, immediately the right hand side should be placed. Yeah. Yes. Raincoat or umbrella application which will be placed on the right hand side. It's not market intelligence. Actually, you are saying the Facebook status was placed, the WhatsApp status was lost. But actually, the business intelligence people, they can analyze each and every tweet of you. They can use it for your business, for their business. That is market intelligence. That's what we need. Actually, big data. But you can analyze the data and extract the smart data from it. It's an example. It's a smart data. Actually, feelings are immediately touchy foundation. It's for just for fun. I don't need to be stored in mind. Actually, the thing was, it was raining immediately the umbrella as well as raincoat foundation should be placed in mind. That's fine. So, how to get the data was raining, then it should be mapping. If the data was raining, if equal to rain, I'll say a simple example. If some status equal to rain, then place advertisement, raincoat, and umbrella. It's easy. But raining status, another placing raining status like that. Another one placing just a single dot mouse which will be called as raining. Yeah, it's symbolic representation of you. Many of them are representing you in the sense they specify only. So it's a shortcut code of FB. It's a shortcut code of WhatsApp. Similarly, business intelligent people also understand the shortcut code and make the data smart. That's fine.